Hi, how are you? My name is Alejandro Sandoval, and this is the Solo Negocios video blog for the summary of the Solo Negocios bulletin for today, July the 3rd, 2018. Today, the Mexican peso got appreciated, and mainly due to the Bloomberg Dollar Spot Index, which decreased 0.53%, a strong decrease for this indicator. And this was due more to foreign issues from the US point of view, and obviously Mexico, rather than properly internal issues. Actually, economic indicators from the US shows specifically factory orders better than expected and durable good orders better than expected. So that will imply increase in the strength of the US dollar. But the problems with the trade war, even when the natural trend is to increase the strength of the US dollar, right now decreased it. So that helped the Mexican peso in a great deal. Also, Mr. López Obrador, new president-elect in Mexico, cabinet, the economic group of people that will be working in the economic sector, insisted that they will respect the Mexican central bank autonomy, the Banco de Mexico autonomy, as well as the free-floating system of the Mexican exchange rate. Remember that, or if you didn't know, since 1994 and in the past, we used either a fixed rate or a variable rate under a floating system among a floor position and a maximum position. Well, now and after 1995 and up to today, it's on a free floating system. And this has helped a lot to make like a cushion against the strong volatility. I mean, we have lived a strong volatility since the normalization at the Fed began a topic back in 2014, since the election of Donald Trump in the US in 2016, and obviously recently. So the Mexican peso moves a lot, but the rest of the economy can hold given that cushion. Well, that was important. Also, China's central bank diminished tensions worldwide given this trade war, where it mentioned they won't use the yuan, their currency, as a weapon against them, the trade war, as a weapon that could be swift or interchanged between the tariffs in trade terms and into currency terms. This was feared already and mentioned by different economic commentators worldwide. And well, basically the fear is that if the US keeps pushing with tariffs and those countries affected by them are limited with the tariffs that are available for them to impose into US products, then they will be able to use the yuan, well, in the case of China, the yuan or any exchange rate they have, so they can diminish the or affect the trade with the US, specifically to the US exporters. So if this is true, there will be a greater heat in the global economy. Well, the issue that they are mentioning that they are not doing it, at least today, is tensions for this specific deal. But this following Friday is the due date for the tariffs in the second round tariffs that will be imposed from the US to China. So if there's no negotiation during the week and we don't know about it, well, there will be a lot of tension and worriness about this hit to the global economy. Also, oil went up, and this is helping the market because of the different elements that are cutting production, but also making the US, that is increasing production, to use their inventories. Canadian cuts from their production, given a problem with electricity in a specific production area. Also, Libya's military conflicts that they have. And, well, obviously, the renewed OPEC agreement. All of them are helping oil to increase the value. And, well, obviously, that helps the exchange rates in Mexico. Back to Mexico's exchange hedges, demand was 1.75 times the $400 million offered for 59 days. This implies a little bit less volatility than the previous days, which were low. And also the spread in banks, which is 1.12 pesos per dollar, diminished 2 cents respect yesterday. And the future in the future markets of the Chicago Mercantile Exchange, they showed also a decrease in the expectations for, or the forecast for 2018, the month of December specifically. This is the information we have for today. Thank you very much for your attention. We'll see you tomorrow again. Thank you.